Hey guys, it's Morgs and welcome back to episode 4 of our Sheffield Wednesday FIFA 16 career mode. Now last episode was without a doubt the best episode so far. I'll give you a quick recap. Just before the episode ended, we signed Divock Origi for 5.5 million, I believe. 5.4 million, that's right. And we also scored a really nice long shot and got some great results in the league. So, the first thing we're going to do just before we carry on with this career mode is get a squad report, look at if anyone's grown yet. As you can see, Palmer's grown by 1, Tom Lee's by 1, and then Falkler 1, Barry Bannon 1, and then we have Iheanacho, who we've been giving individual training to, who's grown by 2 ratings, Kamano's grown by 1, we have also got Wallace and Price both losing 1 rating, and Poodle growing 1 rating. As well as Vermeil growing a rating, who is out on loan. So guys, our first match of this episode is going to be an away game at Birmingham. It's a pretty boring game, so we are going to simulate it. As you can see, this is the squad I've gone for. Almost every player is on form, except for Matthias and Origi. But we want to give Origi a game, obviously, and Matthias is one of our best players, so we can't really leave him out. So, we are underway against Birmingham away. That rhymed and I didn't even mean for it to. Okay, so Birmingham took the lead and it was their right back, I believe. That's not the best start. Surely we can get the equaliser though. Come on, Wednesday. Oh no, we're 2-0 down. What the hell? We're going to need a miracle. Come on, Wednesday, pull it out. Surely not. We're at one trap for our first loss. They've had a player sent off. Surely we can get at least one goal. No, we can't. A 2-0 defeat away at Birmingham. What a shocking result that is. Here we have a match at home to QPR in the Championship. I'm going to play this because that's one of the most exciting fixtures. In terms of the team, we're going to put Origi on the wing and Zhao up front. So get rid of Matthias just because he's been performing really average. And yeah, Westwood's out on international duty. So we're going to bring in, I guess, since Price is 2, it's going to have to be Wildsmith. Okay, here we are, guys. The match is underway. Oh, it's a brilliant ball from QPR. He's completely unmarked. Oh, what a miss. It was completely unmarked, Leroy Fair, and he just managed to smash it wide. QPR do have Charlie Austin playing, who was a target for us in the transfer window, so it'll be a bit annoying if he scores. Oh, it's a brilliant play. Sees Origi's run. It's a decent little ball. Can he take it down? Nobody's beat his men. Origi on the left here. Might do a bit of skill. Cuts in. Goes for the finesse. Oh, the keeper just grabbed it. Not bad from Divock Origi. Zhao wins the ball. Falls here to... Who is it? It's Origi. Oh, he beats 2 men. He's just got to beat that last man. Can he just run past him? No. Oh, it's a brilliant bit of defending from QPR. Oh, he's hit the crossbar. It was a defensive error from us, passing the ball out when we should have just been clearing our lines. And it's felt, I think, Austin who's hit the crossbar. We are pretty lucky not to be losing this game. We need to do better in the second half. And there's half time. I'm not going to lie to you guys, we are doing really poor. We're going to keep it like it is for a few more minutes and then we're probably going to have to make a sub. Okay, so the substitution we are going to make is Matthias for Zhao, and we're going to put Matthias on the left and stick Origi up front. Hopefully Origi can perform in the second half because we really need the goal now more than ever. Oh, it's a brilliant through ball from them. They found Charlie Austin and it's a goal. This is fucking terrible. We are doing absolutely shit this game. We can barely get a touch and when we can, all we do is fucking lose it. This is the first time this series I've really been thoroughly disappointed with the team. Nice ball to Matthias. He's got one man to beat. Gonna go out wide. Can he beat those 2 men now? Gonna cut in. He's done so well here, Matthias. Matthias! Oh, it's just a shit finish. We just can't finish our fucking dinner. It's not been the first time this series where we've been unable to finish our chances. Matthias has done so well to get past the men, but he just hasn't applied the finish. Guys, there's only one thing I can think to do for the last 10 minutes of the match, and that's sub on Iheanacho, the wonder kid. Origi, I'm not going to lie, has been absolutely terrible that match. It's a really poor start for him to this series, but I'm going to give him time because obviously he's young, but it's not the best start to this series, unfortunately. Oh, look at that for a clearance. Straight to their player. What are we doing? Now Sugu on the right. Surely we can get something from this attack. He's got men all around him. He's going to play it through here to Tom Lees, who is up. Good ball to Matthias. Matthias through to Iheanacho. It's a great little bit of play here. Iheanacho's going to cut in. Cuts in again. Iheanacho! Iheanacho! He's done it! The Wonder Kids come off the bench to score the winner. Oh my goodness, guys. What a goal from Kelechi Iheanacho. He got it on the left. Skilled about three players. And in the 90th minute, the super sub Iheanacho has come off the bench to get us the equaliser. Unbelievable scenes here. And there we go, guys. That is the end of the match. Now, my mood has just been boosted by a lot because we have come away with a draw. I didn't mind a draw at the start of the game because QPR are probably the best team in the championship. So a draw against them is a pretty good result. We did probably not deserve the draw. They did have a lot more chances than us. But in the end, Iheanacho coming on in the 82nd minute to get the goal in the 90th minute. Absolutely brilliant. So we have got an international management offer from Northern Ireland. I'm not going to take any international role unless it's like Brazil or something really big, just because it just distracts us from the actual series. We have actually got a training session now, so we are going to do it, as always, all to Iheanacho. So I'll show you what we pick in a minute. Okay, so there are the ones we have gone for. We've gone for sharpshooting, beat your man, headers and volleys, pass mastery, and assisted free kicks. If you look at Iheanacho's rating in terms of 69 to 70, he's pretty close to the 70. So I'm hoping we can get him up a rating from this training drill. Let's have a look. Is he going to do it? Yes, 70 rated Iheanacho. So as you guys can probably guess, he comes straight into the starting lineup after a brilliant performance. Matthias actually came on and did very well, so we are going to go with him as well. So Matthias, Iheanacho and Sugu, McGugan. We are going to switch out McGugan for Bannon. I know he's off form, but I just feel Bannon has more quality. And we've also swapped out Latchman for Browning because Latchman was off form. So straight after our home fixture against QPR, we are away at Hull, who are probably the second best team in the championship. So another game we are going to play, a very exciting one here. And the match is underway. Oh no, no, oh what a save from, oh no. We forgot to put Westwood back into the team. That reminds me, Wildsmith is still in the team, but he has just pulled off a really good save, so we'll not slate him too much. Oh, it's a wonderful goal. It's an absolute wonder strike. You can't take anything away from that. Who even is it? It's Livermore. That's what happens with these Premier League players. If you give them space, they'll score from long distance. So 1-0 down here early on in the game. To be honest, we've barely even had a touch. It's been another poor start for us. We are just not doing the best at the moment against these tougher oppositions. Oh, they've hit the crossbar. Seems like every team hits the crossbar against us, but seriously, we are getting absolutely raped and they've hit the post. This is horrific, guys. We're going to go defensive. We cannot take this quality of passing play. This is a nice tidy bit of play here with Liam Palmer. Going to look for the overlap. Good bit of play. Going to swing the ball in. Not bad. Falls out to Alex Lopez. Lopez with the shot and it's gone in. A huge deflection. But Alex Lopez has got himself another goal from outside of the box. He seems to be the king of long shots at the moment. I mean, it was a huge deflection, like, but it was still a brilliant goal. And it's 1-1. Very undeserved, in my opinion. But we have stepped up our play and we're not doing too bad now. Oh, we forced him out for a throw. Guys, we're pushing on the pressure now. We're doing very well. Picks out Alex Lopez. You don't want to give him that much space. It's a good effort. Matthias. Oh, and it's his goal. I thought he was offside. It's not offside and it's 2-1. The dream is coming true, guys. Alex Lopez causing problems once again with this long shot. Palms it out with the keeper. Falls straight to Matthias for the tap-in. But Alex Lopez once again being an absolute monster in the midfield. And Matthias just finishing the chance. 2-1 Sheffield Wednesday. Oh. Could be a possible counter-attack from the corner, maybe. Iheanacho, going to go for the long ball. Oh, it's blocked well from the Hull player. Oh, here we go. Oh, no. The whistle blew just as we were on a really dangerous counter-attack. That is annoying, but it is half-time. We're winning 2-1, and we are doing pretty well, so I'm going to leave the lineup the exact same. So we're going to go for Matthias and Iheanacho up front. We're going to go for Lopez at cam, and then Lee and Bannon in midfield. And we're going to take off Sugu and bring on another defender. and it's going to have to be Latchman and then put Folker back on the left. Oh, well done from the keeper. That was really dangerous, to be honest, but he's come out and he's done well. Can he get there? Can Iheanacho get there? Of course he can. He's going to look to cut in here. Waits for the run. Run of Matthias. Matthias, and he's done it. He's 3-1. Marco Matthias with another goal. Brilliant from the kid. He's doing wonderful. It was my decision to bring him back into the squad, and it looks like I made a good one because he scored his second goal. As you can see, Iheanacho plays him through here. The first shot was terrible, but he followed it up with a little cheeky header. Very good from Marco Matthias, and it's 3-1 Sheffield Wednesday now. No! Oh, no, they've got one back. It was really lucky from the free kick, to be honest. It was a well-worked free kick. Found Dawson on the back post, completely unmarked. Really poor from us, but it's 2-3. Hopefully, we can protect this win. Good header out. Falls to Matthias. He's got one man to beat. Can he get past him? Yes, he can. Surely Matthias for the hat-trick. He's just got to slot it past the keeper. No, he's missed it. Oh, no. That was for the hat-trick. Matthias, mate, what are you doing? That's so fucking unlucky there. Oh, no. He's putting a ball. It's a good ball. Oh, my God. Get it out. Jesus Christ, that was close. And there we go. Full time after that game, but fucking hell, that got close towards the end and pretty fucking scary. We've held on to it, though, and we've got the win. So, well done. 2-3 Sheffield Wednesday. So, we do have a match home to Reading, but we will be doing that in the next episode, as we've already played 3 games this episode. So, taking a look at the league, we are in the playoff area. We are 5th on 13 points. QPR are top with 20 points. Derby 2nd, Fulham, Leeds, us, then Middlesbrough. Hull are actually 10th, so they're not doing too well at the moment. Iheanacho's actually gone up by 3 ratings now, as I mentioned earlier. He is looking like a really good signing. But that wraps up this episode, guys. So guys, I felt like doing the outro on my brand new camera. If you haven't seen the video of me unboxing it and testing it out yesterday, then go and check that out. I uploaded it yesterday. But yeah, thank you guys a lot for watching this career mode episode. Any feedback or anything to do with the career mode that you would like to see, leave in the comments below. We got some pretty good results. It was a pretty good episode. But if you have enjoyed them, please leave a like. If we could aim for 95 likes on this video, that'd be insane. If we could push for 100, that'd also be really good. If you are new, then hit that subscribe button. I upload every day FIFA content and other games. So I've been Morgs, you guys been awesome, and I will see you guys later. Peace out.